Principal Shaptiru, Vice Principal Rajshekhar, Dr. Senthil, Pallavi, thank you for a long introduction, and other dignitaries on the dais. Students, the function is yours today, and the parents. First of all, I congratulate the students who have joined this course to be the postgraduates at the end of 2 years. And I thank the parents for selecting this institute for their ward's studies. Before I go on to, as a doctor, what's the relationship between these two departments to a doctor or to a hospital? Food we eat has got a very significant impact on our health. My wife is very crazy about foods, so somebody told her that you take green tea, you will reduce weight. So for 3 months, she took green tea from morning, afternoon, and evening. And finally, I did not tell her anything. At the end of 3 months, she tells me I not reduced even a bit. Why is that? So I got the opportunity to tell her that if you want to reduce weight by drinking green tea, you have to climb up the mountain, pluck the green tea leaf, come down, make tea, and drink it. Then you will reduce the weight. So dietetics plays a very key role in public health. And it promotes a healthy lifestyle through better nutrition. If you look at the diseases which prevails today as far as nutrition is concerned, at the one end of the spectrum is malnutrition. At the other end of the spectrum is the obesity. One end of the spectrum, malnutrition. You look at the countries which have got malnutrition. They remain underdeveloped. For years together, they remain underdeveloped. The life expectancy of the people in that country are 30 to 35 years. Why? The children die very early because of malnutrition. The effect of this malnourishment on the growth and development of a nation is very huge. Forget about the other end of the spectrum, the middle spectrum, where a lot of diseases affect the people. You look at India, which is the global capital of diabetic. For at least last 15 years, now the China has taken over as the global capital. We are happy about that. And that will be only for 2 to 3 years. And once our population overtakes China's population, we will be again number one. And we are still number one in cardiovascular diseases, blood pressure, cancers, all these needs nutrition, both for curative and preventive aspect of it. If you look at hypertension or blood pressure, what you call it, or a diabetes, if it starts, and if you, within 2 years of it starting, if you modify your diet, if you reduce your weight by 10% of your weight, the disease gets completely cured. So that is where the role of nutrition and dietetics comes. You can cure the disease. Let us look at the other end of the spectrum, the obesity. Mostly attributed, it's a disease of the developed countries because of the junk food. So what happens at the end? Today, there's a different spectrum of diseases suffered by the developed countries because of the obesity. Obesity prevails in younger generation. At the age of 35, 40, people get diabetes. People get heart attacks at the age of 35, 40. People's bones are fragile. That is my department. They fall down and get fractures, all because of the obesity. What this is going to do in the future, in another 20 to 25 years, the life expectancy of the person in the country is going to come down. You can imagine the impact on the society. These diseases, which can be prevented, cured, or controlled by just dietetics and nutrition. And what is the economical impact on a country. So you can imagine, instead of the country, you think of a community. What's the role of a dietetics and nutrition to the community? So it is important to inculcate healthy eating habits to the society to have a healthy living and improve the health status of that particular community. It's also important to know the cultural and ethnic differences in a society when you prescribe diet. Some of you may be from North India, I don't know, few of you may be from outside the country also. You come to South India, you see that the people eat with their hands. The food here, which is prepared, is meant to be eaten with the hand. And if you eat with the hand the same food, it looks very gracious, caressing. If you try to eat the same food with the Western way, it is difficult. So that is the cultural and traditional aspects which influences when you create a diet or a nutrition to that particular society. There's a long feud going on between a few of my friends. We tend to eat most of the time with the hand. When you eat with the hand, there are few sensations in the hand. You know the temperature of the food which you are eating. You don't know the softness of the food which you are eating. So your system prepares by producing that type of juice which is necessary. And you lift the food in the hand. You know that this is the temperature with which it can be put in your mouth. Most of the time, sometimes you put a fork and then eat it and then you have to throw because it is too hot. So such a thing never happens when you eat with hand. So there is a preparation system for that particular food when you eat it with the hand. So these are the few ethnic things one has to remember when you go to a society. At the same time, if you go to China, if you try to eat with the hand, it's quite difficult. Those food are meant to be eaten with chopsticks. So food and nutrition has got a tremendous variation, both ethnic and cultural. Wherever you go, it is important to have these balances. Hospitality, the next step of it, which is like receiving guests in a spirit of goodwill, especially when you have strangers in front of you. Hospitality means warmth, respect, and protection. Finally, you bring up understanding and appreciation among two cultures. That is what you are going to do ultimately. If you look at hospitality word, it came from what is called hospes. It's a Latin word. The hospes derived from a word called hostis. The meaning of hostis is stranger. So you produce hospes to a hostis, that is a stranger, and that becomes hospitality, the spirit of goodwill. From the same word has developed hospital, host, hostel, hotel. Now you know the relationship of all these. It's a single word from where it is derived. And what's the interlink between all these things? The distance between two centers have decreased over a period of time. May not be literally. If you look at the pre-independence era when Gandhiji traveled from India to London for a roundtable conference and came back, it was 3 months for a three-day roundtable conference. And today, within 24 hours, you can fly to London, finish your business in 12 hours and come back. The distance remained the same, but the time has reduced. It's a good thing. People want to see more of the world. They want to travel. And when they travel, they want to be comfortable. This industry is around 10% of the GDP of the world today. With the same growth what it has got, if it grows, it will create 328 million jobs by the year 2025. And it will be one of the leading industries in the world because everybody wants to travel and wants to see the other countries. So what does it do? This industry will boost the jobs in the places, boost the economy in the regions, can influence the local industry, build an infrastructure in that particular place, and preserve local tradition. Today you find many countries living and thriving on tourism. Their economy depends upon tourism. Hospitality and tourism is an industry that benefits almost every sector in the economy of a nation. So it's an important branch. Students, you have taken up two very good branches which has got a very bright future in the society and also in the economic development of a country. I wish you all the best and thank you very much.